Hey everyone, welcome back to Playcrastination, Population 117. Today we are playing The Average Everyday Adventures of Samantha Brown. I hope this music isn't too loud for you because it is actually blasting my eardrum to pieces. But I think I literally have OBS set at like 4, so it shouldn't be too loud. We'll find out after though. I'd love to have another, what's that game called? Conker's Bad Fur Day situation up in here. Anyway, this game is a free-to-play game on Steam right now, and I picked it even though I usually try to pick something with at least good reviews, but these were mixed. There were some good, some bad. I picked it because of the description. The goal of this game is, your name is Samantha Brown, obviously, so I'll have to get a sex change to be able to play this, but you are a, like, extremely shy, introverted college student, and your goal is to make some oatmeal in the dormitory building community kitchen. I almost called it a fridge. That is not where you make oatmeal, kids. The kitchen. You want to get to the kitchen, but because you have like a lot of anxiety and stuff, it's hard for you to get up and go do that. And you know, as someone who lived for 2 years I'm in college right now, and then for the first 2 years you lived in a place where you had to go to the kitchen to make stuff, and there could be people in there, I can relate to this so well. So we're gonna go ahead and start. And now I've heard, like I said, from the reviews, gameplay mechanics are apparently a little lacking, but that's okay. Let me see where to begin. Somewhere in the middle of a country lived a girl. Is this it's like UK, right? Am I crazy? This is UK. It's poorly drawn, but it's the UK nonetheless. Look, good looking arrow though. Well, to be slightly more specific, the girl lived at a university in the middle of the country. That's exactly you're describing me. She lived in one of the most, except for the female part, she lived in one of the most remote dorms on the university's campus. But no one at her school called it a dorm. They called it a flat. So that's what she called it. Alright, we call ours dorms. Oh, thought that was something else, but it's a laptop. We're good. Her name was Samantha, so there wasn't anything in particular. My reading skills are rough. Anything particularly interesting about her? It was just another weeknight, or maybe it was the weekend. Samantha wasn't entirely sure, nor did she really care. Samantha spends most of her time alone in her room. The only time she's not in her room is when she's in class, at the library, or hiding in a corner somewhere drinking coffee. I mean, that's a strange place to drink coffee. Most people would go to Starbucks, but this is a oddly sensual little what's this animal called? Cat. That's it. Samantha's been sitting in her bed for the last 6 hours waiting for everyone to fall asleep. She's hoping to catch the kitchen in a rare state of abandonment. I know that feel, girl. You have a head so flat you could set this alarm clock on and it wouldn't slip off. And this is where we join her. Oh, before I forget, watch out for the hunger meter. Oh, man, we got a hunger meter. Seriously, though. How many times were you repeatedly dropped on your head as a child so that it became this flat? Okay, ready. Is this how hungry we are? Okay. It's there to let you know how hungry Sam is getting, but be careful. Too many wrong decisions and something terrible could happen. We could get really hungry? What do you mean by terrible? Did you just raise the bar because I clicked that option? I'm not entirely okay with that, Miss Flathead. Oh, you call these dorm buildings flat. That doesn't mean you have to have that flat head. I guess I mean terrible, extremely distressing, bad, or serious. Alright then, please carry on and don't raise my hunger meter. Ah, one more thing. To move forward in the story, simply click on the dialogue box. If you need to return to the main menu, click the upper left corner. Your progress will be automatically saved, so you can continue your quest at any time. It's a quest! It's a quest to get to the kitchen! Well, that's it for me. Good luck. I'm so ready. Who is this? Am I Sam Cat? And dude, you think a Sam Cat and this dog are gonna do well together? You're incorrect. You need to find a better soulmate. Hey, what'd you do today, my sweets? Charbot. Hey, not much. Just hung out with the cat. What about you? I'm the cat. Meh, the usual. Did some homework, watched my show, drank obscene amounts of coffee. So, do you think anyone would be in the kitchen right now? I don't know. What time is it there? Like 10:30-ish. If it's like my university, there's definitely people in the kitchen. I sometimes would go there and make, we'd go to Walmart, buy some crab rangoon, and then go to the kitchen and make it like 2:30 in the morning. Also, why do you care if anyone's in the kitchen? If I make up some excuse, will I feel better? I think if I tell the truth, it'll be more stressful, but I feel like you should be open. Did it go up? Did that go up? Because I want to go make oatmeal, but I don't want anyone to see me making the oatmeal. If this guy's mean to me, I swear. Do you really think people care? Hey, it's possible. That's a weird looking face with a... this is a face that got just shot in the head recently or something because there's a giant hole in it. Ready. What is that, like, little... do you hear the little chatter in the background? Is that like these ads over here? Have you had dinner yet? Well, not really. Sam! Well, I was going to get food, but then the grocery store was closed, and... do grocery stores close? I guess I shop at Walmart, so that's how fancy I am. Why is there a Grim Reaper on the show? What are you watching on the side here? Is this Netflix? This is a weird-looking Grim Reaper. I was watching my show, and I was all... I could go make oatmeal or just eat a flapjack from the vending machine. They sell those in vending machines? Do they have, like, separate cert? You have to pay a dollar for a flapjack and then a dollar... for the syrup? Okay. But I'm still not entirely sure what a flapjack is, so... you meant to say flatjack. It's your friend Jack, who also has a flathead. Sam, don't be silly. Go make yourself some food. Fine, I swear if I see anyone. Okay. Battle stations, guys. Battle armor ready. Put on my helmet. Here I go. A few minutes later. I thought it said a few. It was five. I can do this. That's a dull pencil. You need a sharpener. Just have to get out of bed, get the oatmeal, and walk to the kitchen. That's easy. People walk to the kitchens every day. She's not wrong. See, the oatmeal's just right over there. Okay, I'm officially out of bed. Which kind of oatmeal do I feel like today? Decision, decision, decision. Blueberry and cream is out. That's disgusting. My two favorite flavors. I hate oatmeal, first of all. Oatmeal is actually disgusting. It's like... I'm a consistency kind of eater. I can eat, doesn't matter how good it tastes, if its consistency is disgusting, I'll vomit. And it's usually the consistency of vomit that makes me want to vomit, so therefore oatmeal is very vomity. So even though I love apples and cinnamon flavor, would eat that on anything, can't do oatmeal. So, but I do love these two. If I was going to pick a flavor, it's going to be one of these two. I'm going apple cinnamon. Yas, you can't see, but my hands are raised. Yas, that's the one I want. Now I just have to figure out how many packets to make. Should I make one, two, or three? Dude, go hard. If you're gonna make oatmeal. Whoops. Three? No way I can eat three packets of flippin' oatmeal. That's like 190 grams of sugar or something. What if someone saw me eating three entire packets? They'd be all like, how can someone even consume that much oatmeal at once? Have you ever seen me put down food? I could consume that much oatmeal. Okay. Let's try again. Okay, one package, she's gonna be like, but I didn't eat dinner and I'm hungry. So two. Two seems appropriate. Two says, I'm hungry, but I'm not a cow. Kids out there, it's important to know what message you're conveying with your oatmeal addiction. Two is totally a reasonable amount of oatmeal for someone to eat. Ha! Woo! I made a choice. Look at me making choices like an adult. Wait a sec, though. I still need something to eat this with. Ah, what do we have here? And now it's time to play. What am I playing? There's some great snare drum happening. Yo. What is this game? I oddly love it, but at the same time, what am I playing? Okay, the only game so where you choose that spoon. Please choose that spoon. Is it just like, grab the spoon? You win! Tell them what they've won! I'm pretty sure I missed the spoon. You won an amazing all-purpose eating utensil worth an estimated value of $999.95! Fantastic. Alright, now I just have to grab my mug and off we go. You have a big box of oatmeal. And a really cute hedgehog slipper up there. Okay. Alright. Mug check. Oatmeal check. Spoon? Yep, I played the game show. I think that's it. Wait, just hang on a minute. What if someone's in the hallway? I mean, should I go out there right this second? Just go already! I'm bad at making decisions. Whoa. I just got an achievement adventure as if this is freaking Fallout. Whoa. I have to walk all the way down there. I'm never gonna make it. Just take it slow. You got this. Yeah, there you go. Just take it slow. I'll just take a deep breath and everything will be fine. Yep, everything's totally good. Oh my god. There, that's a little better. I'm no longer tripping on LSD. I just have to take this one step at a time. The thing is, I'm just not a people person. I tried to tell everyone, but did they listen? No. I mean, communal kitchens? That's the worst possible idea. Here you go, eat in front of a bunch of complete strangers. How about no? How about I eat in the safety and comfort of my own room? No one would bother me then. Yeah, that's a much better idea. But here I am, creeping like a creeper. I knew a door was gonna open, dude. She's gonna throw up everywhere. Bah! Oh, shoot. Shit. Is someone coming? Okay, false alarm. The door just creaked magically. Onward. I just want to eat my oatmeal in peace. I don't want to see anyone. I don't want to hear anyone. I don't want to feel anyone. I don't want to put... Never mind. And I sure as hell don't want to talk to anyone. Because you know what? The last time I talked to someone, they told me I did my eyeliner wrong. Small eyes. That's what she told me. It made my eyes look small and I should trust her because she knew how to do makeup. These are problems I cannot relate to. Well, what the hell am I doing? I wear makeup every day. Is she saying I don't know how to do my own makeup? Because that's super rude. Girl, like how about you refrain from talking about my face until we've known each other for like 5 minutes, right? Am I right? Is that the light? Oh my god, what if people are in there, or worse? What if they want to eat with me? Dude, she's sweaty. She's just a sweaty individual. Also, that finger, oh, it looks like it's fallen off. Should I go in? You should probably just go in. Alright, it's okay, it's creeping up a little bit, but we're close enough to the kitchen that we're gonna get... Oh no. Nightmare confirmed. Females. One, age 19. One, age 12. Oh no, they have a bag of breast cancer awareness on the table. And also a giant, an hour later, piece of candy. Should I say hello? Do people still say hello to other? You should tweet them. That's what you should do. What should I do? Okay. I want to say she should say hi and confront her fears, but I know me in this situation would absolutely ignore their existence, so do not say anything. Yeah, screw them. It's like, yeah, I'm going to make oatmeal. What about it? Everyone thinks oatmeal's gross, but it's really good and it sweeps cholesterol from the arteries, and that seems important. My doctor once told me that was kind of important. Now she's making me feel bad for not. Is that a freaking steak, a severed tongue, or a sponge? There, I made it. That's like half the battle. Okay, so I can't use any pots and pans because I don't technically own any, but there is an electric kettle. I'm assuming anyone can use that? Oh, the music's back. This is where the climax is about to happen. I remember in the student orientation guide, it said all communal kitchens came with a kettle, so they must be talking about this kettle, I think. I've never actually used one of these before, but it can't be that hard to figure out. Still, you think there'd be instructions somewhere. What's that coil about? Do I take that thing out? Oh, come on. That doesn't even make sense. Bah, I'm just gonna fill the kettle up. What's the worst that could happen? It explodes. That's the worst that could happen. This seems to be going well. Dude, we're about to be confronted. She's gonna be like, that's my kettle! Just have to avoid being electrocuted. We seem to have avoided being electrocuted. Now what? Do I wait here while this heats up, or should I go back to my room? I wonder what everyone else does. I guess it doesn't make sense for me to go all the way back to my room, because then I will have to walk all the way back here. That seems like a horrible idea, and I hate exercise. Meh, what should I do? It is a time decision? Time is of the essence in this decision? Oh my god, I only have 30 seconds to... I dropped my headphone, man. I gotta put my headphone back, and I wonder if that will make it to where I don't have enough time to pick my decision. Ugh. Are you sure the kettle's even on? Wait, how am I supposed to know if it's on? There's no light or anything. Okay, to avoid the problem of it not being on, let's go ahead and ask someone for help. The timer. I didn't realize the timer was for multiple questions. That's baloney. I'll get the oatmeal into the mug. That's something I can do. Yo, I said ask someone for help. Oatmeal in the mug. Break it open. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Put it in the... Yo, that's gonna be cold. Oatmeal ruined. No. give it a quick stir with the magic spoon. I want, if it's cold, if this is cold oatmeal, if I botched this, and now I wait. Wait for what? For it to... Oh my god. They're laughing at my oatmeal, or perhaps the bow that is tied around... Oh, that's my hair, never mind. What's so funny? Oh god. They're probably just, you know, watching Key and Peele online or something. It's a thing college kids do sometimes. Thanks, Sam. What the heck can I do to waste time while this cooks? Because I can't just stand here looking at oatmeal like an idiot. Hide in the corner. That'll make you look real, real special. Go ahead and clean. Do some cleaning. There you go. Hunger meter's going up a bit, but it's fine. Yes, cleaning. That's a totally normal person thing to do. Cleaning is a legitimate reason for someone to be in the kitchen for an extended period of time. There's a timer. What is the timer for? The oatmeal cooking? Just rub the sponge all over everything. Just rub it right on these packets of oatmeal. That's where you want to be cleaning. All right, we are still cleaning. 2 seconds left. 1, 0. If they laugh again. Finally. Please, oh please, be something resembling cooked food. How is this not even close to being done? Great, great. Now what? Try the microwave? Micro. Beep, 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 beep. Beep, 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 beep. Guys, I'll punch in my phone number. If you want to call me, you can. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, what have I done? What was the question? The answer is always stir it, no matter what the question is. If it's where do babies come from, stir it. Okay. Great sound effects here for us. Okay, I just stir this every few seconds. Yep, gotta cook it. Is that going to increase our stress? It's okay, it's okay. We're going to have oatmeal by the end of this. I believe in a thing called oatmeal. This looks like an ear on the edge of the cup. 3, 2, 1, done. Stir it again. More stirring. Always more stirring. Never enough stirring of the oatmeal. This cat looks surprisingly happy, even though his eyes look like... This microwave is so freaking loud. Put it back in the microwave. She's getting stressed from this? But you, I hope I don't overcook it. They wouldn't make that an option, right? They wouldn't put overcooking as an option of what you could do to oatmeal, right? If I burn this goddamn oatmeal, I will be so mad. Apparently this game also has multiple endings. However, I probably will not do them all. This will probably be our other one. It's gotta be getting close now. Better safe than sorry. Oh, the stress, the hunger level, it's going up. What if she just dies on the floor? Like when your Sims get too hungry and they just die instantly. Nice. Is this the last stirring? Please tell me this is the last stirring. We've been doing a lot of stirring. This is the great stirring simulator as far as games go. That's it. It's done. It's gotta be fudge cake. That's hot. How the hell am I supposed to get it out of the microwave? You should have gotten a mug that doesn't heat up. Maybe use your shirt. Dude, we're going to spill it all over ourselves and they're going to be mad. Herm, I guess I'll take out the cup first and use my shirt like a glove. This is actually ingenious. Yap, I think this is actually working. I'm leaving so you can have your precious kitchen back. Is she saying that to them? You should probably keep that to yourself. Whew, I made it out of there. Just gotta go. Just gotta get back to my room. Almost there. Unlock the door. I guess I should put my cup down. Yes. Yes, you should. Dude, if someone comes and eats our cup. Here we go. Wait. Where are my keys? What have you done? No! Dude! No! I can't believe I forgot my keys. This happens all the time. This is a very accurate represent. I guess I'll just wait here until someone comes by. Shit. The music is really sad now, and I don't like it. Also, you have a strange piece of wrist right here that's that really, depending on how you look at this, with like, cause here it looks like the hair is behind your hand. I'm missing my show. I need to finish watching Archer, which is a great show, by the way. Sam, where are you? I'm worried. It's okay, I'm just making oatmeal. It's just really difficult. They didn't have instructions on the kettle. Wait, what? Is this the end? Did I not make it back to my room? No! Uh-oh, you fail and Samantha's still hungry. Would you like to... I don't want to fail. I want to succeed. No. Okay, I'll tell you what. I'm going to cut all this out, but I'm going to go through and make some different choices, and I will join you at the very end to see if that changed it. And I'll probably, you know what, I'll probably join you at each decision, because you don't need to see the whole story again. We'll just join you at each decision, and we'll see if we can make this work. I'm going to try again. Oh, it starts you right back off after you've picked your... What if I want blueberries and cream this time? Maybe I want blueberries and cream. Come on. Okay, I think that's it. Wait on just a second. Wait, if someone's in the hallway. Okay, so this time, we're not going to go straight out. We're going to say no, and then she's going to realize she forgot her keys. What about the things? It's a little stressful. Keys. I can't believe I almost forgot my keys. Okay, everything should be fine now, so now I'll join you at the end. Alright, the oatmeal's done. We have our keys this time. We're going back to our room. Just gotta get back to my room. Almost there. Unlock my door. I guess I should put my cup down. Yes, yes, you should. Oh my god, we are gonna make it. Here we go. Okay then. Almost. Woo. Oatmeal achieved. Hello, room. I missed you. Goodbye, world. Boosh. I did it. I, Samantha H. Brown, have made oatmeal. And now, I eat. Huh, and you know what? That wasn't even so bad. Congratulations, you helped Samantha make oatmeal, yes! We have achieved oatmeal. It's the only thing greater in life than achieving orgasm. But, as far as a pseudo-review of this game goes, if you will, obviously it's free-to-play, and, you know, for a free-to-play game, I think it's okay. I actually like it. I know the gameplay mechanics aren't great. I don't think it's that big a criticism. I don't think you can have that big a criticism of it, especially compared to some of the other visual novel simulators we've played. This one at least was kind of funny, so I enjoyed that. And you know, it does highlight kind of, you know, there are people like this. I'm not quite to this degree, but I am definitely an introverted person, so I can definitely relate to living in a college dorm and not wanting to go somewhere just because there might be people there. So I can relate to this actually really, really well. So from that aspect of it, I like it a lot. We helped her make oatmeal. Fantastic. That's some oatmeal running down the walls. This is what happens when you achieve oatmeal, like I said. Credits. Here you go. Here's all the credits. We'll let those run. But yeah, I actually enjoyed this quite a bit, so fun little indie game to play. Hope you guys enjoyed it too. Like I said, you can pick it up on Steam for free. It has mixed reviews. You know, I'm probably going to go leave a positive review because I actually think it's pretty good, and I feel like you should just encourage people, unless the game is genuinely terrible, like Gasp, because that just sucked. But this one's actually pretty good. Okay, now how do I get out of the credits? Now, how does one get out of the credits? Okay, it's 2016 lemonsuckergames.com. Is it just going to take us back to the menu? Menu, I assume. Thanks for playing. You are quite welcome. How do I leave this? How do I escape? Okay, back to main screen. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure you subscribe to become a citizen of Playcrastination today. And I will see you guys tomorrow.